अरे कि साउंड बता दे
प्लीज कैलकुलेटर्स अरे
भाई तो
बोला था मैं किसी से बट आई थैंक सीनियर इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज एंड स्पेशली स्पेशल थैंक्स टू प्रोफेसर बद्रीनाथ सर फॉर गिविंग मी दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी टू डिलीवर योर लेक्चर ऑन मल्टीबायोटिक्स. Okay, shall we start? Actually, in the morning, because we generally organize in the morning, afternoon everybody is sleeping. So I will try my level best to wake you up, myself and other people. So how many people have heard about biometrics? Okay. I will make this subject more generic because my intention was to have an idea of what is biometrics. Anyway, the other terms, technical details, you may be learning in internet and so many, but you should know what is biometrics. So first, actually, before we go to multibiometrics, first, what is biometrics? Then slowly we can move on to multibiometrics. So this is the outline of presentation today. I will try to make it more quick as early as possible. So first I will introduce what is biometrics and what are the types of biometrics. Then I will explain what is the fingerprint identification system as well as the facial recognition system. And then I will explain how these two biometrics can be combined with your multi-purpose biometrics and multi-biometrics. Then I have some two case studies which we have system and it is the introduction for them. And I will show you how the people like Aadhaar, Facebook, Foundation Register. I will show some examples. In many stages, the identity management systems, most of them relied on the cryptographic codes, passwords, credit cards, and tokens. So if you want to access something, what do you do to get a password? Or if you want to pay some tax payment, this is the server of the application. So, how the biometrics is going to help in this activity? We have had so many cyber crimes in the world last year. All these problems are there. To increase the security and to increase the So these are the biometrics identifiers commonly heard biometric fingerprint identification in the other so many identifiers going on. And hand creation, as you can you are holding something, the grip pressure which will exert at the device, that is also found to be. So these are all the skills of the identification of the items. And thumbprint, recently in the Western world, they found that the thumbprint also found to be by each human being. And the thumbprint. And still we use to buy the technology since fingerprints are long been declared as a private and organized accurate identification in our India, only the technology are complete for the regulation in the now actually we are using the signature now regulation is very less than the only thing. So the means to get the mass manually to find out the
You can capture the camera, you can capture the video.
So there is a joke that about face of the in the world, lot of going on. Recently, one month back, NDC are the all the writing. You might have they mentioned to buy they put the DNA from the collective and then put the DNA actually kept it offshore machine. So that DNA in the helicopter can put that case and they verified the DNA. So then it is matched, that one is the request to it. So actually even for the software, so they are really part one of the conversation to all the tools. So DNA has a very good advantage, but we can identify the information for every cell in the body in a digital form. But it's not as fully automated. So the digital unit is identical to this, we have the same DNA. But in the normal biometrics, identification is different. Fingerprint is different. For the calibrations of the human being or between the two people, all of them are different. Even for the twins of the fingerprints is different. But here, this limitation is there in the DNA. And there are primary issues. The DNA will give information on the race and any diseases, chronic diseases, and all this information, privacy information will be lost in the DNA. So there are some restrictions. So there is a difference between the conventional biometrics and DNA. It requires actual physical shape. And you use this because we need to have the discuss sample, we have to take the biopsy from the DNA. But here, for the other biometrics, only we have to use whether the camera or some to capture the data. It is not possible in real time, but this condition of biometrics can be done in real time. There is a comparison of actual samples, it is generated based on the temperature match. Because DNA is able to do the biopsy mapping. But in the biometrics, from the UPS, will generate the template, and the template is matched with the other template. So that is the third one. Is that, so there is a difference between iris and retina. Iris is the area surrounding the pupil. But here, it is a plasma blood vessels that template from the RCM and disperse over the retina, depends on the individual. Never changes. Both two retinas are the same used for the identical. That is the advantage enough. But actually capturing the retina will be difficult when compared to iris. The normal paper you can capture the iris image, but retina we have to use some complicated. This is the thermograph based on your temperature, heat pack. The scientists have found that the heat pattern generated is the power using for the two things. So, so this is the ultimate biometric, everybody is waiting for that. So, the game is for every human being, the way you walk, the way you stand, the way you sit. And all will be unique. So, systems are working on to find out every human being from a long distance based on his features, standing, and looking. So, they will measure the features like this. And then, this probe, the reasons with which one types at a keyboard are sufficiently restricted to form the basis of the biometric technology and physical requirements. So, it is 100% software based, requiring no sensor, more software than a home computer. So, this is based on the behavior pattern, not on the physical observer. Then, the ear retraction. So, ear commonly exists at least this ear also how to be unique shape for the human being. So, the shapes and patterns of the human ear are widely different. And infrared is just a second. The ear retraction of problem will be 8 degrees. Have a, so, to remove the loss, it is not possible to get the image with an arm. So, for that, we have to use infrared images. So, these are the features. they found them unique. So what was the biometric identification is in here. So these pieces have to be concerned. And the screen reflection, the Lumidium is an international biometric company. The reflection in a particular radiation is also different for the UV. So using that also, we can do the fingerprint action, the biometric identification. And they also for the lip motion, the lip, how you are walking, what you move, and when you are walking, how you are lifting. This is the recent observation. So they found that each human being, the odor, the smell of the body is also found. So using that, you can identify the person, even for the mouth candidates, you can. So within India, also, you can have the different, the scientists found that the unique pattern. Heart sound, actually recently some scientists have found that the heart sound is unique for the human being. And the echocardiogram, ECG, also found to be unique for the human being. And this is the general after the measurement is captured, we will apply different features for the getting the results, gender, ethnicity, height, size. Overall, these are all the biometrics I have given. So now see, what is the biometric system? Now you see the types. So typically, what is the biometric system? So for example, if you take the same example, our human brain, what is it? The images with the eyes. There will be cancer defect. So, even for the biometric system, also, we require one to one. Absolutely. So, if your heart can be camera, I can be a thermal. So, there is a required sensor to capture it. We have to think about it because the brain is very complex. So from that feature, then the generated temperature. The temperature is stored in the data. Take an example. You are given some, you are given some ID number. that is known the data the match is okay. Then there is so this is a extractor under the match. Then there will be some database. Then the application. So all these actually the affairs and they will charge accordingly. This does not support they will charge. So they are recording their attendance with the encrypted ID. My number is this. This thing is after the from that a live template is then it is matched with the whole database. Then it is matched with the whole database. For example, 1 million packages are there. You have to match with the 1 million packages. System is there. Then that is we are only absence of any system is environmental conditions, biological conditions, climatic conditions, and the carbon will have. These are the points because the human being the department because it is a combination system. It is only actually, biometric identification it is only a probability. So, it will only say similar to matching. So, it will not be the exact, and only it will say out of 100, just 80% of the match was matched. That is what they should carefully. And the same of so this the false accusation rate. So since it is a competition and it's a probability of finding, there will be a chance of that. For example, suppose the false acceptance rate is 1/100. Then suppose 100 fingerprints are bad, then you make chances that one will be one another certificate can be alone. So that is the false acceptance. Anybody following because false acceptance is most important. Biometric should understand this, otherwise, nothing to be able to find. So false means, for example, you have the 100 return. If you use this algorithm for the identification matching, there may be a chance that out of 100 records, one unidentified person may be alone. So it is very dangerous. FAR is very dangerous. There may be a chance that
Thank you.
will stand up to that, will rate the data. All of these that we clarified. So these are the templates and how to identify the thesis like this. From the features that you will generate a template. So this is called Unisha. This is the graph for the Unisha. And after that you will do matching like this. This is matching like this. So based on that you will generate the possible matching thresholds. Now it comes to the spatial recognition system. It is environment, suppose it is in lab environment. But in the life, what is personal? All the species, they are all looking for the means. So if you want to have a good match, we are extracting all. So the match is going to be ready. We want to have a speed of the Thank you.